Welcome to a new video, everybody. Today we're going to be replacing the stock automatic shift knob with a nice aftermarket manual shift knob. Now, you may be wondering how that's going to work because the stock shifter knob has a little button on the side of it that allows you to switch your gears when you're pressing on the brake, and this doesn't have any kind of buttons on it whatsoever. So let me go ahead and show you what all I got to get this setup working, and then we'll get it installed. Alrighty, so here's everything that comes in the kit that I ordered from Six Speed. I'll be leaving a link for it in the description below in case you want to pick it up for your car. But basically, they give you this little adapter here and then these little sheaths that fit inside of it to attach where your current knob is. And then on the top, it has some threads, and I ordered a nice huge red shifter that I think would go well on the inside of the car. And then they give you a little Allen wrench and some set screws to hold it all in there. So let's go ahead and get the stock shifter removed, and then we'll put this one in there. The first step in taking the stock knob off is going to be freeing this leather boot from the center console here. So you basically want to grab the leather pretty firmly and just pull straight up, and then you should have all these little clips dislodge from where it's attached in that center console. And then what I suggest doing is going ahead and putting the parking brake on, and then we're going to shift into neutral and then pull straight up on the stock knob here to get it to detach from the little post down here. Once we've got the knob off, you can kind of see how things work down here. So whenever you press the button that's on the side, there's a mechanism on the inside of this knob that presses this little piece of plastic down, and that allows you to shift the gears. So basically, instead of pressing this button to have that activate the mechanism, we're going to be using the adapter in here to push down on this, and then we'll be able to shift the gears. Next, we're going to use the stock piece of boot that we currently have because I don't have a custom piece yet. I'd like to get some red leather up in there eventually, but for right now, we're going to be using this stock piece. So basically, you just want to roll the leather up until you can see where the knob is connecting to the rest of this centerpiece, and you're just going to push in these two little tabs on either side, just with like your key or a little screwdriver, and that's going to free the knob from the rest of all the leather and everything here. Now that we have the stock knob removed, we can go ahead and put our boot back into place here. You're basically just going to feed that over the shifter and then put the piece back in place so that all the clips just go back in there and you shouldn't be feeling any of them sticking up. Next, we want to go ahead and get into these little sheaths that we were talking about. You want to see which one is going to fit over your shifter the best and make sure it's a snug fit, because that's going to hold the shifter in place and make sure it's not wobbling around when you're actually doing your shifting. And then once you've found the correct sheath, you want to go ahead and make sure that you're lining up the hole where the screw is going to go with this hole back here in the back of the adapter. Now, they do give you a little bit of wiggle room just because some of these buttons are a little taller or shorter than others. So you wanna make sure that whenever you're pressing it down, you're getting it to go all the way down so you can make your shift. So that's gonna help you basically get the right height that you will need. So we'll go ahead and put the screw in and get that attached on here. You may also want to think about where this set screw is going to be visible whenever you're done with the install. I'm going to go ahead and point mine facing forward so that I'm not able to see it. Alrighty, so after tightening the set screw all the way in, I noticed a little bit of a problem. When it goes all the way into the hole here for the adapter, it then allows the adapter to spin left and right freely, and I definitely don't want that. So I went ahead and I just got a little bolt that actually has like a regular screw head so it will hold those sides in. It's nice and sturdy now. And now we just have to go ahead and screw our new shift knob on. Now, they do make some different size threads and adapters. If you find a different knob that you like better and want to put it on there, all you'll do is just screw it onto the top of these threads and then into whatever shifter you like. So let's go ahead and start the car and see if this thing works. And now to shift, all we've simply got to do is press down. And we go through all of our different gears. We can even go over here into the electronic shifting, go up and down, move back over to drive, put it back up into park, and see, it's not coming out of those gears unless you push that mechanism down. Thank you so much for stopping by and checking out the video. If you have any questions about the install or the shifter or adapter, let me know in the comments. Again, I'll be leaving a link in the description below if you want to pick one of these up for your car. Go ahead and check out another video on the channel while you're here, and hit that subscribe button if you're not already subscribed. Again, thank you so much for stopping by and checking out the video, and I hope to see you in my next one.